Hey, hi guys, this is Sushant,
and
today we are going to talk about what are maintenance calories. So maintenance calories are the amount of calories that you need to eat in a day to maintain your weight. So I have talked about this thing in my previous video, that if you're burning X amount of calories in a day, then if you're eating more than X calories, then you'll be gaining weight. If you eat less than X amount of calories, then you'll be losing weight. So let's say you are burning 2000 calories in a day, then if you eat 2000 calories, that is your maintenance calories. So the amount of calories you burn in a day is your maintenance calorie. So because if you eat the amount of calories that you're burning in a day, your weight will not change, it will be maintained. So again, what is maintenance calories? Maintenance calories are the amount of calories that you need to eat in a day to maintain your weight, and that is equal to the amount of calories you are burning.
Okay, so calories burned
is equal to calories eaten, then you maintain your weight. Calories in is equal to calories out. It means that the calories that you took in to your body is equal to the calories that got out of your body, not by vomiting or loose motions or stool passouts. Calories out means the calories that the body burnt. So basically the calories that you took in is equal to calories that went out by the body burning the energy.
So basically calories in versus calories out
is in equal ratio.
So these terms are usually CECO and calories burned,
calories eaten. These terms are usually used on the internet, that's why I mentioned them over here.
Okay, so for example
of maintenance calories, I'll take a few examples for you to understand it better.
Let's say someday you did your household work,
your body burned some energy in your daily routine, and that energy was 2100 calories.
B is for burnt, E is
for eaten.
So you burned 2100 calories and you had eaten
2100 calories in that day. So your weight will be maintained.
The amount of energy that you burned
is your maintenance calories, because if you
eat that much amount of calories,
your weight will be maintained.
Okay,
and if you do not understand this, you can watch my previous video. I have talked about how do you gain or lose weight in my previous video,
and all my videos
come in a sequence. So if you
watch a video and if you do not
understand anything, you can go and watch my previous videos.
They form the base for the current video.
Okay, day 2.
My body burned 2500
calories. Let's say on the day 2 I did everything same as day 1, so I burned 2100 calories, but I decided to run and I went for running, let's say running some X distance, X
amount of distance. So in that running
I burned 400 calories more than yesterday, than day 1. So on whole I burned 2500 calories, and on the second day also I ate what I ate on the first day, so I ate only 2100 calories. So I basically ate
400 less calories than I burned,
and I've talked about this in my previous video, that 800 calories is 100 grams. If you eat 800 calories, you'll get 100 grams of weight.
So on this day I ate
400 less calories, so I lost 50 grams of weight.
Now day 3, I did everything
same as day 2 on day 3.
I burned again
2500 calories. I went for running and I did the household work, everything was same. But what happened was I ate at home and I ate 2100 calories, and then I went outside with my friends and I ate outside. And then I ate additional 800 calories, and the total sum came out to be 2900 calories for the day. So basically
I burned 2500
and I ate 2900. Then
I basically ate 400 more calories for that day.
So I kind of gained 50 grams of weight on that day. But if you look at it from an overall perspective, on day one I burned 2100, I ate 2100. On day two I ate 400 less, and on day three I ate 400 more. So on a whole perspective, I maintained my weight across the 3 days. My weight will not change across the 3 days.
Now, if we talk about a week, let's say any 5 days of the week, not necessarily consecutive,
maybe Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, Saturday, Sunday,
any 5 days of the week,
let's say I was eating 200 calories more than I was burning in that day. So I did that for 5 days. So basically 200 into 5
is 1000 calories. So
as a whole, on total 5 days, I ate 1000 calories more. And the rest 2 days, I ate 500 less calories than I was burning.
So basically for
2 days, I was eating 500 less calories. So I basically on a whole ate 1000 less calories in those 2 days. So if you look from whole week perspective, then in the 5 days I ate 1000 calories more than I was burning across those 5 days, and for 2 days I ate 1000 calories less than what I was burning across those 2 days. So on a whole week my weight will be maintained.
Okay, now that goes for
2 weeks also. Let's say in week one, I ate 2000 calories more than what I was burning, and in week two I ate 2000 calories less than what I was burning in that week. And overall in the 2 weeks I will maintain my weight. Now this is all just to understand that calories maintenance work this way. You can see
the weight maintenance in 10 days, not necessarily 1 week or 2 weeks.
You can see it in across months, you can see across 15 days, 1 month. But most of the times, I think 99% of the times, what you need to know about is just 1 day. So you ate, let's say, X amount of calories in that day, and you burned X amount of calories in that day, so you have maintained your weight for that day. So 99% of the times, you need to
just be thinking about 1 day. So
you do not need to go in so much complication. Okay, and these calculations are approximate. Looking at this, it feels like so it is very hard to know that. First of all, it is hard to calculate the amount amount of calories in your food exactly, and secondly, it is kind of almost, I think, impossible to calculate the amount of calories that your body is burning in a day. So your body might be burning 2537 calories in 1 day. So it is not very exactly like 2500 or 2100, and it is not easy to calculate. So
we work on approximations.
We talk on approximations. Writing 2500, 2100 looks good on paper, but it is not what actually happens. In reality, you will work on approximation that my maintenance calorie should be around this, like that.
And how to calculate
your maintenance calories, I'll talk about it in the next video. I'll take one more example for maintenance calories. So
my 2 videos back, I talked about where does our body burn energy.
So there were
three components of it: the BMR, the
activity that we perform in digesting the food. So let's say today I burnt, let's say my BMR is 1500, and doing the household work I burned 750 calories more today. So on a whole I burned 2250 calories.
And let's say I ate 2500
calories.
But
around 10% of those calories were used in
digesting those calories. That's what I talked about
in my video, 2 videos back I talked about it.
So So 250 calories
out of those 2500 calories, approximately 250 calories were used in digesting that food. So I burned 2250 calories because of my BMR and the daily activity I was performing, and then this much energy was used for digesting the food. So total I burned 2250 plus 250, which is 2500 calories I burnt in that day, and I ate 2500 calories. So I will be maintaining my weight because I burnt 2500 calories, including the energy that was burnt in the digestion of the food, and I ate 2500 calories. So that is about maintenance calories. These examples are not to make things complex, they are just to make you understand better. Don't be afraid of them. At most you need to know about calories in versus calories out for one day, not for multiple days or multiple weeks or months. And you just need to remember that maintenance calories are the calories at which you can maintain your weight, and you will maintain your weight when you eat the amount of calories that you are burning. So basically maintenance calories are the amount of calories that you burn every day or that you burn in a day. Like this video, please like it. If you have anything to say, put them put it in the comment box. If you like the channel, please subscribe. If you want to receive notification for my future videos, turn the notifications on. I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.